Gigantic Orthopedics, and my area of focus is total joint replacement surgery, principally hip and knee replacements. What Mako Robotics is it allows us to take advantage of something called haptics technology, and it allows us to replace the hip and knee versus doing it with manual instrumentation. And what haptics technology specifically is it allows us to take advantage of touch and sensation and integrate it with computer application via radars, via sensors, and infrared signals so that the computer and the person who's doing the operation are always in intimate contact with each other, leading to optimal results for the person.
Okay. And what I thought was really cool, back on August 1st, I was reading Union Leader, and here it is, you're right on there. So I really want to learn more about, you know, what you're doing, not only as a surgeon, but also as a trainer for Mako. And then I also read, too, you're going to India to do a lot of training there. So please share with myself and the Facebook Live audience what's going on with that.
So this is really an exciting time. Mako started launching its availability in joint replacement surgery roughly around 2006. And since that time, they've performed over 50,000 partial knee replacement surgeries and over 10,000 hip replacement surgeries. In 2016, it was a monumental year. They were finally able to integrate computer application and robotics and subsequently superimpose it onto full knee replacement surgery. Now, the benefits of this technology is we're taking a knee replacement that has an excellent track record for over 15 years and then subsequently combining that with taking advantage of what robotics has to offer. And when we're talking about robotics, we really break it down into three simple segments. There's a preoperative planning phase, where we're able to get a 3D scan of the patient utilizing the CT that allows us to create a model of that individual's knee. And that model can be customized and personalized to fit and contour that person's anatomy perfectly. The second segment of Mako Robotics is ideal functional positioning of the implant. Essentially, what that means is when the person comes into the operating room, once we put sensors onto the leg, the sensors and the robot recognize each other, and that preoperative CT scan will pop up on the computer screen as we see here. And what we can do now is we can take advantage of something called dynamic evaluation. When we're moving and straightening and extending the knee, when we're positioning it in different ways, what it allows us to do, it allows us to ideally position the implant by translating the implant in any direction that we want, creating an ideal resection both on the femur and on the tibia, so each and every single time the implants are perfectly placed for that individual patient. And the third segment for Mako Robotics is that the robot actually allows us and it assists us in making those resections so that each and every time it's absolutely perfect. When you compare that, when we're doing a manual total knee replacement, what we're talking about with a manual total knee replacement is we're using guides very similar to the ones that I laid out here to help us determine the size of the implant, to help us determine which angle that we're supposed to put the parts into place. And basically, we're taking advantage only of our previous experience and eyeballing it to account for something that can be as accurate as 0.1 degrees or 1 millimeter in any direction that we want.
Okay.
The thing with the training piece of it is, as it stands now, over 200 surgeons have performed 5,000 total knee replacements on the robotic arm already. The projected number is supposed to grow to over 1,000 over the course of the next 12 to 15 months. So the exciting time right now is that, you know, I've had the opportunity to go across the country to train and teach surgeons and integrate different hospitals for robotics so that they can subsequently offer this technology to their own personal patients. In addition to that, Mako Robotics is not limiting themselves to just the United States. They're expanding to the international market. And in September, I'm really excited to tell you that myself and a group of two other surgeons are going to head down towards India and launch Mako Robotics in India.
Well, that's pretty cool. So, I mean, here it is, you're at a national level, but at the same time, you know, we've got some of the best right here at Portsmouth Regional Hospital. So what I'd like to do is, you know, really talk about me as a patient. I come to you, Portsmouth now has this brand new, beautiful Mako robot. You know, why should I get this done? Really, what's the benefit to me as well as to yourself? Like, talk about recovery.
Yeah.
You know, reduction in narcotics. Really, let's kind of focus on that.
Yeah. So if you look at overall satisfaction scores for individual patients that have undergone a knee replacement in the past, it doesn't matter who actually performs the operation, but overall, the success rate for knee replacement surgery, at least in terms of patient satisfaction, is roughly about 75%. And there are certain underlying parameters that could potentially be the reason to why 25 to 30% of the people are not happy, whether it's malpositioning of the implant, which now we can account for with robotics, whether it's proper sizing of the implant, which we can now account for with robotics, and also something called soft tissue tolerances, where, you know, when we're doing a manual knee, we may perhaps be over or under correcting the alignment based on the x-rays that were presented to us in the office. Now we can take advantage of what that individual's knee is feeling like as it's going throughout the range of motion. The second segment of your question, as far as perioperative pain control, Portsmouth has really been a pioneer, a leader, if you will, in the state of New Hampshire as far as perioperative pain control is concerned. We have an excellent anesthesiology team here that does amazing nerve blocks to really mitigate the pain associated with a big operation such as this. In addition to that, we have access to wonderful intra-articular injections such as Exparel. Exparel is a medication that we can inject at the time of surgery, so the dependence and reliance of narcotics has gone down significantly, and most of these patients are able to go home within 24 hours, and they're able to function at a very, very high level within 4 to 6 weeks. In addition to that, because we can be so accurate with implementation of robotics, what we have found in our experience is that patients seem to get their range of motion more quickly, and the one thing that a patient, even a successful knee replacement patient, will say is that it's hard to restore that natural feel after they have an operation like this. But I think that with robotics, we can get them that sensation to be more in line with perhaps what it felt like prior to developing the arthritis.
And now let's talk back to that patient. You're saying, you know, 4 to 6 weeks. Are there any limitations afterwards? You know, I mean, whether you're picking up your grandkids or if you're a golfer, what limitations do these patients have?
Yeah, I think when we're talking about hip and knee replacement surgery, it's a little bit different. When it comes to hip replacement surgery, the recovery tends to be exponentially fast. When we're talking about partial knee replacement surgery, it also follows a similar path to a hip replacement. And most of those patients are able to perform daily activities and transition into sport within 4 to 6 weeks. A knee replacement sometimes can take a little bit longer. It's more of, it's a larger surgical dissection. There's more bone that is being resected out. So really, I would say that most patients are able to transition back to the fun things that they want to do roughly between 6 and 10 weeks.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, that's really the goal is, you know, coming up with the surgery, but I want to go back and resume normal life. Still using some PT afterwards? I'm sure you're recommending that to your patients.
Yeah, I think PT is an integral part of recovering from a knee replacement. Fortunately, even with the application of robotics, we don't really have to deviate from the PT protocols that are currently instituted or in place with knee replacement surgery. What we have found with the feedback from the physical therapist is that they're simply hitting their benchmarks at a faster clip, and that's the exciting part. And I think it makes a lot of sense. If we can contour and tailor and fit a knee replacement for that each individual knee, and we can mitigate the amount of surgical dissection and mitigate the amount of exposure that is required to gain access to the knee, that should subsequently lead to faster, better recovery and a more natural feel to their replacement.
Anything else you'd like to share with the Facebook Live folks? You know, we covered, you know, you as the trainer, you know, you here as the Mako, you know, robotic assisted, you know, surgeon here at Portsmouth. What other, you know, one last little tidbits can you share, you know, why is to choose this technology? What's developing, what's going on with that? Anything?
Well, I would say that sometimes visual aids are extremely effective in making a discernible feature between one versus another. when you're having a manual knee replacement done, you're really relying on what I call 2D or instrumentation or visualization as far as the replacement is concerned. What we're dealing with robotics is 3D live intraoperative dynamic evaluation of the knee that just simply is unparalleled. There's really no technology that's even close to what we can offer patients with robotics.
Okay. Well, I know that I'm very excited, and I really want to encourage our Facebook, viewers out there, for more information, please visit PortsmouthRegionalHospital.com. And I know that on August 22nd, which is only about a few weeks away, over the Manchester Country Club, of course, in Manchester, New Hampshire, you're going to be doing a live talk. So patients have the opportunity to come and speak to you, ask questions. You're pretty excited about that? I know I am.
I am. I love doing outreach talks. I think it's a great way to engage with people about their particular afflictions. And in addition to that, it gives me a great opportunity to educate them about what their underlying problems are, what potential surgical and non-operative solutions may be available to try to get them back into the things that they want to do most.
All right, so come see and talk to Dr. Sastry. Please visit PortsmouthRegionalHospital.com. There'll be a link also on our Facebook page where you can register for that event. And we'd like to thank you, and please join us again for our next Facebook Live. Thank you, Dr. Sastry.